This is Miss Sebastian, and we're going to look at summarizing distributions. Okay, what are the best measures of center for this data set? So the mean and median are both measures of center for the data set. When a distribution is, and this one is uniform, that means every data point is the same there, or normal, the mean and the median are equal. Therefore, both
the mean
and the median represent the data correctly or accurately. Sorry. Okay? The mean and the median are both measures of center for a data set. When a data is skewed left or skewed right, the mean is pulled away from the center of the distribution, therefore the mean does not accurately represent the data. For skewed distributions, the median is a better measure of center. Okay, for which distributions is the median the best measure of center? Anything that is skewed left or right. So these two, this one is skewed to the right, this one is skewed to the left. This one is uniform, and uniform, both the mean and the median are the best. And this one is normal, so the mean and the median are both equal. So we wouldn't say that the median is the best, we'd say they both work. So your answer here would be just the first column. To determine the most popular selling size of a new sandal, a store manager records the sizes of sandals sold one weekend. What measures of central tendency best describe the data? So the first thing we need to do is put them in order from least to greatest. So I see a 6, a 6.5, 1, 2, 3/7. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4/8. Three nines. And 2/10. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is find the median. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Let me count that again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah, 14 total. Okay, that means that I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these two are my center or my median. That's 8. And then I'm going to find my mean. And I've got to do that by adding them all up and dividing by 14. So I'm going to start adding. I've got 6, 6.5, 7, 7, 7. And then 8, 8, 8, 8, 9, 9, 9, and 10 and 10 divided by 14. I do have a median of 8.0. So this is pretty normally distributed. So either the mean or the median would work for this distribution. The line plot shows the numerical data gathered for a statistical observation. How many observations were made in gathering the data set? So all I'm going to do is count up the number of X's on my line plot. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So there were 14 observations. Same thing, how many observations were made in gathering this data? So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So now, it wants me to find the mean and the median of this data set. So I've got to look at my first column and I see 1 four times. Then I see 2 three times. Then I see 3 six times. Then I see 4 five times. And then I see 5 three times. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find the median. So I'm going to count up all my numbers and see how many I've got. I've got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So I have 21 numbers total. So number 11 will be my median, which is 3. Now I'm just going to add all my numbers up to find the mean. So I've got 4 ones, 3 twos, 6 threes, 5 fours, and 3 fives. I'm going to divide that by 21, and I do get that the mean is also 3. So this has a pretty normal distribution, because both the mean and the median are equal. Okay, so we're going to find the mean and the median again. We've got 4 ones. We have 3 twos. We've got 2 threes. And we've got 5 fours. Okay, so we're going to count up the total number of numbers. We've got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 total. So I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And there should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I've got to find the middle of 2 and 3. The middle of 2 and 3 is 2.5. Okay, now when I add all those up, 4 ones plus 3 twos plus 2 threes plus 5 fours, I get 36. And I do need to divide that by 14 because there were 14 total numbers. And it tells me that this is about 2.6. Okay, what's the mean, median, and the range of this data set? So I'm going to add them all up. I've got 1, 1, 5 twos, 3 threes, 4 fours, 2 fives. OK, Okay, so I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 numbers. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, the different, or the average of 3 and 3 is 3. That's our median. And when I add them all up, I do get 47. And there were 16 numbers. So I'm going to divide that, and I'd get 2.9 for the mean. And the range, remember, is just the highest minus the lowest. So 5 minus 1 tells me that my range is 4. Okay, we're going to look at another line plot. And I'm going to add these up. I've got 2, 2, and 2, 3. 4, 4, 4, and 4, 5, 5, and 5, and 6, and 6. Okay, so I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 numbers. So number 7 is the median, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so it is 4. Oops, let's put it down here. And there were 13 numbers. When I add up 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 6 plus 6, I do get 52. And when I divide 52 by 13, I get 4. And my range is the highest number, which is 6, minus the lowest number. And so my range is also 4. Okay, let's look at this one. We've got 3, 3, and 3. Four, or 5 4s. 2 5s, a 6, and a 7. So I'm going to count how many I've got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I have 12 numbers. So I'm going to have 6 on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my median is the average of 4 and 4, which is just 4. And then I'm going to add them up. 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 5 4s plus 5 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. That is 52. And I'm going to divide that by the number of numbers I had, which was 12. And that gives me 4.3. And then last but not least, we have the range, which is the highest number minus the lowest number. So that range is 4. Okay, what is the interquartile range of this data set? So the first thing we do is we find the center. That's our median. Okay, and then remember the middle of the first set and the middle of the second set. So the interquartile range is those subtracted. 7 minus 3 is 4. Okay, what is true about this distribution? Okay, so we need to find our median. Okay, just the middle. And we're going to find our interquartile range by finding the quarter one median. So halfway between 12 and 13 is 12 and a half. And 16 and 17, 16 and a half. So when we subtract those, we get 4. And then what you're going to do is you're going to say, okay, 4 times 1 and a half That'll be six. If none of the values are either six above or six below your quartile one or quartile three, you have no outliers. So because you have no outliers, you can use either the interquartile range or just the range, okay, to show the variability of the distribution. So let's find the interquartile range of this. We've got 11, 13, 14, 16, 17, 18, and 19. Okay, so we've got seven numbers. So the fourth is our median. That one's out of the running. And our center number, our quartile one number is 13. Quartile two number is 18. So our interquartile range is just those two subtracted, which gives us 5. Okay, which measure of variability, the interquartile range or the range, accurately describes the distribution? Well, when you look at the first one, it's medium to large dog weights. You see that the 63 is like way over to the right. So all of these are pretty close, but then you have this one that's way over here to the right. So we don't want to use the range. We want to say that the interquartile range, where all the data is centered, is a better measure. Okay? Only because you're looking for where is most of the data. Now, if you look at this second one, all that data is pretty concentrated, all in the same thing. There's none with a really long line out to the right or a really long line out to the left. So both of these will be a good representation.